Hi everyone, greetings of the day. In this webinar series, today we are going to learn about AI meets the art. That means how with the help of artificial intelligence, we can create some good arts, how we can make some creative arts with the help of different platforms are available. So today's webinar topic is how AI meets the art. Generate the stunning visuals with Artbreeder. So here we are going to use the tool Artbreeder, which is freely available. So we are trying to explore that how we can create the art with respect to Gen AI tools, in which our main focus will be we will explore the AI powered creativity, transform the digital art with machine learning. So behind this, whatever the Artbreeder or any such type of applications are present, behind this AI and Gen AI technologies are present. So we are going to see about that. Thank you so much for joining me today. Myself Suraj, currently pursuing the PhD in artificial intelligence domain. My previous educational background is in electronics domain. I did my UG and PG both in electronics. I'm a certified trainer from Microsoft. Also, I did so many certification with respect to beginner level, intermediate level or associate level. So recently I passed with the Azure AI engineer as well as data science engineer. These are two associate level examination. I'm a certified data scientist. Regarding my work experience, I have 12 years of experience as a corporate trainer, and I deliver the training to Indian as well as international clients. Regarding my the research and all things, my research is tilt maximum towards the data science, machine learning, deep learning, artificial intelligence, Gen AI technology, natural language processing. Along with that, I work with some of the technologies like computer vision, Internet of Things, wireless communication, like that. Regarding my research and publication, I published 20 plus papers in reputed journals, including IEEE, elsewhere, like that. And also I published two books in Lambert, Germany, which are available on Amazon also. Now let's go with this, our topic. That means how we can use the artificial intelligence for art creation, or with the help of AI algorithms, how we can create the different arts. So here we are going to learn about those. So first point is how, what is mean by AI generated art, AI generated art defined. Then we will go with some GAN in creativity. I will tell you about how GAN actually works with that. Then digital art transformation. Now, when we consider the AI generated art defined, that means machine learning models create a unique visual composition. Now, let's try to understand what is mean by machine learning. So machine learning is basically subpart or subset of artificial intelligence, in which machine have the capability to learn something from the previous data. That means it's not a magical thing. Machine is going to directly creating the arts. No, it's not happening. So machines are already trained with the large amount of data, recorded data or historical data. And depending upon that, these machines are going to do something. That means these machines are going to predict something. That means these machines already trained with such some sort of data, and from that learning, whatever the machine learn from that data, it is going to do some new predictions, it is going to do some new generation. That is, it is going to generate something. So machine learning models are basically responsible to learn something and predict something or generate something. Now, when we consider the machine learning, actually this technology is basically previously used at the start of artificial intelligence practical application, but it has some limitation. That means this machine learning only works with the some, what I can say, structured type of data. That is data present in tabular format. It consists of number of rows, number of columns. But if we provide the unstructured type of data. That means if our data is present in image format, if our data is present in video format, if our data is present in audio format, that time machine learning algorithms are not playing well. That means the performance of machine learning algorithms is not good while working with the images or videos. Now, by considering this point, suppose if I have to create the art, that means we need some innovative, and that will came with the different images, different video, different animations, something like that, but which is not possible with the help of machine learning. So what happened? See, machine learning is the base. We require the machine learning, all the concept, but machine learning algorithms are not good or well suited with the unstructured data like an image, video or animation. So we have to take care of that. So we have to remove or minimize that limitation. So after that, there is one another terminology came into the picture called as a deep learning. Now, actually, what happens in the deep learning, the name itself specifies that now machine have the capability to learn something bit deeper way. That means they are going to learn something in bit deeper way. There is that algorithms are going to extract the main information from images. They are going to read the images in appropriate way. They are going to work with the videos. They are going to work with the animation. And because of this, deep learning is a very good field, or I can say it is one of the good era under the artificial intelligence, through which we can work with the structured data as well as we can work with the unstructured data. Now here we got data, different deep learning algorithms are very good when we have to work with the images, video or animation. See, I'm mainly focusing here on the images, video and animation because our today's topic is we are going to use the artificial intelligence in art related field. So my major focus will be on image, video and animation, because with the help of image, video and animation, we can create such type of arts in artificial with the help of artificial intelligence. Now, once the deep learning came into the picture, along with this deep learning, so many algorithms came into the picture. Let me list some algorithms so that you will get the idea. So under the deep learning, mainly came algorithms are, let me start with the basic, that is initial algorithm, that is ANN, artificial neural network, which is base algorithm, which is going to work with the images also, but in not a good way, that is not in full-fledged way. Then there is one breakthrough happened and we got one very good algorithm called as a CNN, that is convolutional neural network, which is a good algorithm when we have to work with the images. So basically convolutional neural network algorithm very good plays with the images, video or animation. But again, this CNN got some limitation. That means when we have to generate some new images, that time CNN does not have that capability to generate something. So after CNN, in between so many algorithms came, and after that, there is one good algorithm came into the picture, GAN. So GAN is nothing but generative adversarial network. So let us bit deeply try to understand what is mean by GAN. So GAN is nothing but generative adversarial network, which is came under the artificial intelligence and basically deep learning. Generative adversarial network. Now, when I consider the GAN, it is made by using two parameters, that is two network. First one is a generator and second one is a discriminator. So the idea behind this GAN is very simple. One network is going to create or generate something, that is image, video or animation. And second network is going to verify whether that image is real or fake. So basically, if you observe any application which are going to find out whether that image is a real one or edited one or fake one, that time GAN technology is used. Now, how this GAN works? So let me tell you with a block diagram. So for example, if you have the first network, that is a generator network, through which or to which we are providing some noise or samples, and with the help of that, it is going to create one image. Now, this is generated image from the machine. Now, another network is present, which is called as a discriminator. This discriminator network again connected to the generated image this discriminator network have the original images. Now it will compare the generated image from the machine and original image from the which is provided. Now depending upon that, it will gives the idea whether that image is fake one or whether that image is real one. So this is basic fundamental how the GAN works. Now as this GAN network consists of one generative network, that means with the help of GAN we can create so many images. So for example, if you are providing one face and with respect to that face you have to find out similar type of 100 faces, you have to generate similar type of 100 faces, then that is possible with the help of GAN. That means GAN is basically used in terms of find out the creativity or create some good images over there, good animations or good videos over there. Along with that, it have the capability to find out whether that image, video or animation is real or fake. So for this purpose, we use the GAN in creativity way. So as I mentioned, under this GAN, the generative network is responsible for that. Now remember, when I consider the generative network, behind the generative network, again deep learning is present. So generative adversarial network produces the novel artistic outputs. How it is going to generate, I explained just now. With the help of generative network, it is going to generate. Now next is digital art transformation. Transformation in the sense of we are going to transforming one raw image into a clear image, or once we do any sketch, that sketch is also can be converted into real image. That means digital art transformation is possible. For that also, so many nowadays AI tools are available, AI algorithms work with that. Now what actually happens, so let me tell you with one example. So when I consider the digital art transformation, if I did one some small sketch, so for example, I did some sketches with different lines only, and with respect to that lines, I have to create the image. That means from the normal sketch with the help of lines, it is going to create the image. So this is happened with the help of digital art transformation. So you can see in the explanation, it is an AI tool revolution. Creative process and possibilities. So it is going to create something new things. It is going to make some creative things. So again, this digital art transformation is the part of AI in terms of art or when we have to create something innovative. So these are the three points we've seen, that how actually machine learning, deep learning and digital transformation plays a vital role while we are going to work with the art related things. Now, Artbreeder is one of the platform. As we've seen that, as I mentioned, behind such type of AI tools, again, we have the deep learning technology. So Artbreeder is one of the platform. So with the help of this platform, we can do so many things. Basically, this platform is used for the image generation purpose. Just we have to provide the input in our own language, that is natural language. We can say that it is a prompt. And with the help of that input, with the help of that input, it is going to generate some new images. So Artbreeder is one of the good platform through which we can create the images. So you can see the overview of Artbreeder. In the demonstration, I'm going to show you how actually we can use the Artbreeder when we have to create some images or when we have to work with the images. Now here, the basic thing behind the Artbreeder, it have the core functionality. So here you can see core functionality in the sense of it is a AI powered image generation and manipulation tool. So this tool have the capability to generate the image on its own. Just we have to provide the input in terms of our language, human language, and depending upon that, it will generate some images. Also, it have the capability to manipulate the images. Manipulation in the sense of if you have the raw images already, you can upload those images and you can find out the good version of those images. So this is how the core functionality when we have to work with the images in terms of art related things. Then it have again one good capability, that is image combination. image combination means it is going to work with the multiple images and it will gives you the output in different flavors. That means, for example, if you have 5, 6, 7, 8 images and if you provide those images and you have to find the combined image of that or in the good flavor of that image, so it will gives you the different suggestion, that is combination of different images. So you can merge the multiple visuals to create a unique artwork. So if you've seen so many artworks are available, or if you seen such type of artworks which are hanged towards the wall, so such type of unique combinations we can create with the help of this technology, that is with the help of Artbreeder. Next is it have the intuitive interface. Intuitive in the sense of it have the user friendly design for effortless creativity. So remember, one of the major advantage of Artbreeder is when you visit to the Artbreeder, there is no code platform. That means those person which are technically not good with respect to coding part and all, there is good platform to them. That means with the help of Artbreeder, we can generate the good images. Or those people who are good in the art related things, but they are not good in technical part, no need to worry. Artbreeder gives us the solution without code. That is no code platform, we can use that. That is Artbreeder. So this is a very user-friendly design, very easy buttons over there. Just we have to put our thoughts as a prompt, and depending upon that, it will generate a good images. So this is the overall platform overview of the Artbreeder. Now using the Artbreeder, we are going to go with the hands-on walkthrough. So first we have to do the account setup. So quick and free registration process is there. So just you have to go to that website, Artbreeder. I'm going to put that into chat box also, the address for that. Then you have to set up account, very simple steps. Likewise, when you entered or when you set up the account for your Facebook, WhatsApp, same type of things are there, same type of steps are there. Then once your setup is done, you can go either with the your Gmail account or whatever the mail account you have, you can log in with that mail account also, no problem. Then it have the platform navigation. So explore the image categories and creation tool. So once we entered into that, different options are available, different palettes are available, and with the help of those different options or palettes, we can find out some things or different palettes over there. And after that, we can do the feature demonstration. That means we can adjust some traits, more images we can found. Morphological images are nothing but they are going to apply some erosion or dilation type of operations on that. That means we are erode or dilate that image. So such type of morphological operations we can apply that. Once such type of applications or such type of operation apply on that, then we can save and share that image. So this is good platform provided when we have to work with the art related things. And the name also given that Artbreeder. That means with the help of this platform, you can create the innovative ideas, innovative art. So let me show you the demonstration. I'm closing this window and jumping into the web browser. So first you have to just write there Artbreeder in the Google. So it will give you the suggestion. Just click on that. Now here also you can see, once you click on that, you have the option create browse activities and profile. So you have to log in here. So you can see already I logged in over there. So if I log out, it will ask you for the login. So once you entered here, you will able to see such type of screen. Now, just now I logged out from there. Now you can see the tagline for them. So create like never before. That means good tagline. That means you can create such type of images which are very useful in terms of art. So create characters, artworks, and more with multiple tools which are powered by artificial intelligence. So remember, whatever this Artbreeder is going to create or generate or process the images, these are powered by artificial intelligence technology, and basically in that deep learning algorithms are present. Now here you can see 10 million users are using right now this, and 250 million images they created are available over there. So feature tools, you can see composer is there. You can try for free also create or mixing the images text together. So you can try this right now. Okay, let me log in over there and we will go with that another part. So log in with Google. So I'm putting my Google address over here, and through the that Google Gmail account, I'm logging here. Now, once I log in here, now you can see here, create, browse, activities and profile. Through the create portal or platform, you will able to create the images. So you can use the composer, our fastest and most powerful tool for mixing and editing the images. That means you can mix the images, you can edit the images with the help of composer. Again, you have the collager, which is going to assemble the shapes, images and text together. Then below you can see the poser is also available, which is going to combine the faces and different poses. So here you can see face is there, pose is there. So you can see the final image. So prompter is there, turn text into images. Just you have to put the text, it will create the image. Then director is there, create with an AI assistant. So it will give you suggestion and it will create the images. Splicer is there, mix images and edit their gens, create the portrait and more. So you can look into this also. Outpainter is there, which is going to expand any Artbreeder image. And different legacy tools are also available. So let us go with this one by one. Now let me go to the browse option. So under the browse, you will able to see the different images. So this image is already created. This image is also created, and this is under the composer, this is under the collager, this is again under the composer. So such type of images, different images, you can see that which these images are created already. Also, you can see some post over there associated. So here you can see corresponding images created, and you can see the post associated with that. Regarding comments are also there. So likewise, you can see the post tags and who are using right now. So you can see the users also. Okay, so this all information you will able to see under the browse. Then which are the activities done, you can see enter to win. So you can create your images, and also you can submit the images. Whether mismatch, pattern, faulty or ununiquely designed, mix socks, the start of your artwork, submit that. So private images will be set public when voting begins. So some rules, or they are putting some contest over there. You can go for that also. You can do the voting for that also. And finally, we have the profile. So you can see your profile, what you did over there. Now let us go with the create option. I'm going to use this first one, that is poser. So now here you can see you are going to set the pose. So if I set the pose, okay, actually pose I don't have. What I will do, let me set these seated poses. Okay, let me go with these poses. Face I'm going to use the same. A woman in a suit in front of a garden, and I'm going to generate that. Can you see? So here you can see I sit, provide the pose, and in that pose only I can see the shape. Suppose if I change the pose, so I'm going to with torso type of pose or portrait type of pose like this. And if I have to generate, now you will able to see that image. So straightforward portrait type of image you will able to see. Now here you have the options. You can download the image here also. Now when you have to work with your own images, you can upload your own images. You can provide the pose. So suppose if I change this image, if I go with this another image, let me go with this image. And I'm removing this image. Now if I generate this, you will able to see that. Yeah, perfect. Now you can see three images we created. Suppose if I change the pose, let me go to the seated one and I'm selecting first one. Now that person will be seated in the seated position, you will able to see. Okay, so such type of generation, image generation you can do. Now you can do the setting if you required in square format, wide format, tall format. So all such type of information you can specify. Face strength also you can specify. So if I change the face strength, you will able to see that some changes over there. Yeah, face strength you can see it is bit changes over there. So likewise you can perform the task. So this is the first, that is Artbreeder poser is there. Then prompter is also there. Prompter is going to just, you have to put the prompt, and now depending upon the prompt, it will generate the image. So photo of European medieval 40 years old queen, silver hair, highly detailed face, detailed eyes, head shot, intricated crown, age spots and wrinkles. So I specified this description. Now I'm going to generate that image. So it is going to generate the image, but I am not interested in this image. I have to change some parameter. So you can go to the setting. So you can specify here model is the default, or you need the realistic. Let me go with the realistic. Shape is square. Instead of square shape, I will go with the tall one. So it will create the tall shape. I have to put some advanced. So fixed, I'm not providing here. Guidance scale, I'm bit increasing that. Now we are going to generate that. Now you can see if I click on the generate option, now you can see. So the change has happened. Okay, so because of the, we need the realistic image. So it will show the realistic one. And also we made some changes, that is shape is a tall one. Now you can see the tall shape is there. Now advanced options, we kept this 1.8. If I change this to 1.3, now you will able to see that it is bit changing. So it shows like a ang one. So likewise, it is going to create the image. Now if you change this description, if you change this prompt, you will able to see that image, that is as per your choice. So generation size you can increase. You can see the multiple images in a single shot. So this is the one, that is you can go with the prompter. Then again we have the director and director. Chat with me to create my image you like. So you can start a chat. Now what image would you like to create? A low poly parrot. So I'm going to create that, loading that. So here you can see it's a low poly parrot is created. Different options they provided. If I click on this more like this, so it will show you the more images. Yeah, like this. Okay, that means you can use this director platform when we have to do the conversation, and you can go with that. Sorry. Yeah, now let us go with this composer. So with the composer, I put it the prompt, an apple, an elephant and a rabbit on it. Now let us try to generate that. Already it is generated. Let me bit change this. I'm going to remove the rabbit. Let us see the response. An apple and elephant. Now you can see an apple and elephant. Now instead of apple, let me put here banana. Now you can see the response. Apple, banana along with elephant. Suppose if I remove the elephant, now you can see it will show the image for the banana only. Okay, so if I specify here multiple, so it will create the multiple bananas like this. Now once this image is created, you have the that means from this Artbreeder, you can download that image also. So as per your choice, you can specify. So multiple bananas, if I just changes that, you will able to see that. So depending upon that, you can make some variations. You can create the multiple images, different variations. And from those variations, you can select which image is good for you. You can download that. Okay. So here you can see the different variations are created. Now also you can refresh this. You can see the history also. And pause the automatic regeneration. So once you click on that time only it will generate. So you can specify that point. So this can be done with the help of composer. Now here you can see the collager is there. You have to just specify the shape and one another image. So for example, I'm specifying this shape. These shapes you can taken from the right hand side. You can see the palette through which you can take this and you specify what you have to create. So I'm going to specify here, just a second. Palette, I'm considering this. I need one tiny robot by using such type of devices. Now I'm going to render that. Now you can see it will create one robot by using this box and all. It will take bit time. Yeah, now you can see here the robot is created by using that box. So likewise, you can do this. If you re-roll on that, you will go back and you will able to see that. Suppose you have to change this, you can change from the palette. So allow me some time, it's processing. So this robot is created. Let me go a bit back. Again, I will go to the collager instead of this, a tiny robot. Now, instead of this, let me change with this one. Let me remove this, putting this here. Just a second, what is happening? Okay, let me take this. And again, I have to create a tiny robot by using this scope one. Or you can say glasses, those glasses through which I'm going to create. It is going to process, it will take bit time. Can you see? With the help of those glasses, it is going to create. Now similarly, if I go back, I'm going to change that. I will take this one and again, I'm putting the same one. I have to create a robot by using this. Now you can see it is going to create and also you will able to see the background. Now in that case, what you can do, you can change the background. So let me go back and I'm changing the background. I'm removing this background, entering this background here. Okay. And now I'm asking the question. Render a tiny robot. Now you will able to see that background it changed over there. So if you have any shape which is not a defined one, now you can see background it changes. So likewise, you can create your own images with the help of this Artbreeder. You can download from that also. So such type of things you can perform with the help of this college. Now after this composer, you can see our fastest and most powerful tool for mixing and editing the images. So as we seen that. Then collager assemble the shapes and images and text together. Also, you can use the poser, prompter and director. We've seen that. Now let us go with this splicer. Some portraits, new image we will see. Now what I'm going to put here, I'm going to use the original image. One original image I will consider this face, and depending upon that, it is going to generate. Now in that style, it is going to generate. Okay. Now you can specify your face how you require, like this. Okay. Style you can specify, you can increase, decrease like this. Now if I suppose if I made the changes over here, and if I add one another instead of this, let me go with one another, this small child, and I have to generate this. Now you will able to see that. Okay. So here with the help of uploading one images, you can see the different versions associated with that images. So here also you can change the facial color and all such type of things. Then brown hair, when you have to make, you can make this brown like this. So suppose if I generate this, now you can able to see that facial hairs are there, brown hair is there. If I remove this, now it will be better. Yes, brown hairs without facial hair. So likewise, you can specify, suppose I need the blue eyes, and if I generate, you will able to see the blue eyes like this. Okay, you can change the intensity also. So if I make bit small, then it will be better. Perfect. Now you can see. Okay, so likewise, we can generate such type of images as per our need. So this can be done with the splicer and outpainter, which is going to expand your all the library, which is going to paint something. So painting of a man in the field of flowers, and if you generate that, it will create the image. So let me change this instead of flowers. Let me put here fruits. Now if I specify, will take bit time. Yeah, now you can see I specified here a person who is going to paint that with the flowers. Now you can see the response. Okay, now you can download this image, you can upscale this image also, then clear this. You can go back. First you have to close this image, then you can select any image. And painting a man in a fruit, if you specify. Yeah, something like this, it will do that. Now, suppose if I remove this, it is asking for the image which you require. Let me go with this. And I'm putting the same one. It is bit mixing one, mixing of images happen. Yeah, so likewise you can see man mixing with that. That is both images are mixed. So likewise you can go with this, you can try with all these ports, composer, collager, poser, prompter, director, then splicer, out painter. So these are good. You can download those images also. So we've seen this walkthrough demonstration. Now what you can do, maximizing the free access. Actually this Artbreeder having the free access, so you can see. But remember, it have the daily image generation limit. So try to optimize that daily generation limit. Then community sharing is there. Utilize the shared images for inspiration and editing. So already some those images created already over there, you can use those images also. Quality focus, create impactful art within pre-tier constraint. So put the prompt in appropriate way, put the input in appropriate way. Your input should be clear, consistent and reliable, so that you will get the clear, consistent and reliable images. So you have to take care of that. Next is where we can use this Artbreeder. So in different applications in creative industries, we can use the Artbreeder. So for the game design purpose, we can use that. create a unique characters and environments rapidly, because nowadays animation industries are playing very vital role, game industries are playing very vital role, and for that purpose we can create such type of characters which are required in the game, which are required in the animation movies, we can use that. So for the game design, it's a way, good way, because it's showing some good animations which are not impacting or which is not a stolen properties of any human being. So it is a good feature. Then in the animation, you can produce the innovative backgrounds and concept art as per your need. So you can create the animation type of scenario with the help of that art breeder. You can create such type of art. Also, you can create some good characters for the animation movies from that also. Then it is basically used in the digital art. So inspire and enhance the traditional digital artwork. That means for the digital art competition, or when you need any good idea regarding the digital art, so you can take the idea from this. So you can check over there how I can create such type of good image, animated image, mixed image, portrait image. So all such combination you can see with the help of Art Breeder. So these are three applications mentioned here, but not only with limited to these three applications, you can explore beyond that also. In many organizations nowadays, this art breeder is used in many art industries. They are going to use, see, it is going to give us the good reference, good ideas, good animation, good picture with the free version. But if you go with its pro version, definitely the most good features are available. So many features will be unlocked over there, and you can easily utilize that. So these are some applications in creative industry. Now, what is the future of AI art? We know that AI is going to change all the definitions. So with the help of this AI, AI is impacting on the art industries also. So there are some evolving algorithms which are more sophisticated and customizable AI art generation. So with the help of those algorithms, we can create a good images which are good in the art industry. Then we can do the collaborative creation. So AI assistants working alongside human artists. So with the help of the combinations of some ideas from the human artist and ideas from the AI algorithm, we can make the good collaboration and we can find out the good result. At the end of the day, we know that artificial intelligence is science or one technology which are both ends. That means if we are using that in good way, definitely we will get the good result. But if we are using that in bad way, we will get the bad result. So we have to take care of that, and we have to make the good collaboration with the AI algorithms, AI assistant. Then we have to consider some ethical consideration. That means it should not follow or bypass the rule of ethical consideration, like whatever the image is created, that image should not bias anything with respect to gender, with respect to ethnicity, with respect to location. Nothing biasing should be there. Also, whatever the image is created, it's a trustworthy and reliable image should be there. And also, if possible, try to include the people. That means some people are not able to see the images. So we have to provide some input to them. That means how they can provide the input, how they can imagine which type of image is created. So all such type of ethical consideration, we have to take care of that. And last one is the industry impact. Definitely, as the AI creating the good images, it is going to impact on the industry. So reshaping the creative workflows and job roles. Because of this, what happens, in very less amount of time, we are going to create some good work. With the help of this AI gen, AI industry or algorithm, it is going to impacting on the peoples also. That means those peoples who are employed over there, it is impacting on those peoples also. So these are some features of AI art. Now here, as we seen the demonstration, how we can provide the input, then how it is going to create the different images. So base image we provided, face we provided, style we provided. So it is going to create that. So we seen that how we can create such type of images with respect to different combination. Similarly, we've seen that prompter, just we have to give the input. Then after providing the input, if you have to do some setting, you can do that setting, advanced state setting, click on the generate. Within small amount of time, you can see the time also 0.033 second. It takes only to generate the image. That means within less than 1 second, it is going to generate the images. So you can use the prompter. Also, we've seen all the features. Also, you can use the Artbreeder patterns, and with the help of this pattern, you can create the such type of landscapes. So you can use such type of patterns over there, and you can provide the input. Yeah. So what is the conclusion from this, and what are the next steps? So key takeaways from this webinar: AI revolutions, art creation, and accessibility. That means with the help of demonstration, you can imagine that with the help of AI algorithm, nowadays all the definition of industries are changing. In the art industry, big impact is happening over there, and with the help of this impact, what I can say, the creative thoughts are coming, creative ideas are coming, and it is definitely impactful on the peoples in the art industry. So experimentation, you can encourage the hands-on exploration with Artbreeder. So my suggestion will be, please visit to the Artbreeder website, log in over there, and you can try with the different images. You can upload your own images, and you can check the processing, how actually happening with that images. Then community engagement at its best level, free, available, large community is there. So you can share your thoughts, you can share your images. So join AI Art Forum and share the creation. And finally, continuous learning. Remember, learning is only one tool when we have to upgrade something. So continuous learning should be there. Stay updated on AI Art and advancement. So this is regarding our today's webinar. If you have any question, please let me know. You can put your questions in the question and answer section or in chat box. Yeah, Philip, actually there is no such API is there right now. The video creation feature is not available, but they are going to merge that. So in some days you will able to see that video creation feature also. Yeah, Artbreeder is the app. Video creation is not possible right now, but in some days you will able to see the video creation also. Yeah, any other question? If you have any other question, please let me know. You can put in chat box or in question answer section. Yes, you can upload your personal images also. Artbreeder can be interface with other applications. Good question. Yes, there are some integrations are present, but we have to go with the pro version. We have to pay for that. Then we can make the interface with our local applications also, or we can make this integration with different applications also. Yeah, if you miss the webinar, you please connect with the point of contact. Might be another day this webinar will be happen, so you please stay tuned with the POC point of contact. Any other question, please let me know. Yeah, it is interface with possible interface with other applications with but with pro version. I think no other questions. So hope you enjoy the webinar. You can put your feedback in chat box also. One link is provided, so you can fill the feedback through that link also. Thank you. Thanks everyone. Thank you, Daniel. Thank you so much. So regarding the certification, you please fill the feedback, and might be they provided the attendance link also. Yeah, so fill the attendance link and feedback. You will get that. Okay. Yes, you can use this for experimentation research. There is no limitations. You can download the images, and whatever the images you downloaded, no need of any concern from there. That means we have to use those images anywhere or not. Yeah. Thanks, everyone. Thank you. Thank you for your feedback. So Usha Devi, there is no such learn procedure, but try to explore that because steps are very simple. Just visit to the Artbreeder link already I provided, and with the help of that you can try to explore some every day some sort of what we can do, what we can apply other thing. So all such type of things you try to explore. Again, I am putting the link for Artbreeder. You please go through that link. Okay. So everyone, with this I'm taking your link. Thank you so much for joining us today. And thank you so much for your valuable feedback. Have a nice day ahead. Stay tuned. Bye bye.